Hey, what's up, guys? My name is Quincy, and I'm going to tell you why buying followers on TikTok, Instagram, and YouTube subscribers is a bad idea. I'm going to share with you the findings and the results coming up next. So I get it. You want to be TikTok famous overnight. You want to have these followers, and you want the numbers to reflect that you have clout. Having clout is totally different from actually being famous. We're gonna review an unnamed account, and I'm gonna show you what people look for as far as brands, sponsors, companies, when looking at your account, and how it can affect you if you're thinking about buying followers or if you've already bought followers, and what not to do and what to do right away. If you wanna be Instagram famous, or if you wanna be TikTok famous, or even have 1,000 subscribers on YouTube, you can purchase those followers or subscribers in a matter of a minute. It's just within a click of a button. But is it worth it? Make sure you stay to the end of the video, because I'm gonna share with you what I did on Instagram in buying followers, just because I was curious to see what would happen. I share those results with you, so make sure you watch till the end. So right now, we are going to go over an unnamed account on TikTok. No names mentioned, but just to show you where you can tell they bought followers and how it's gonna affect their account. But before we do that, why buy followers? What can you get with 1 million followers on any platform? Usually what happens is brands and companies are looking for someone who has a high following because they see that there is a potential to market their services or products through that person being an influencer and getting a return on investment because of their large following, because of their fan base. But what people that buy followers fail to realize is having that high following number above your profile picture does not guarantee you that a company is going to now all of a sudden want to sponsor you or give you a brand deal because they see 1 million followers. And why is that? Because there's no engagement. What is engagement? Engagement is when there's comments going back and forth between you and your fans. Legit comments, not robotic comments. So let's go ahead and take a look at someone's TikTok account whose name I've already blurred out, and we're gonna show you what companies look at. So if I'm a company and I see that you have 1 million followers, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to go to a website called Social Blade, and I'm going to see all of your different platforms and see your engagement. I'm gonna see how many followers you have, when you started, when you got those followers, and it's gonna show basically everything behind the scenes that you don't see when looking at someone's account at face value. Let's go ahead and go to it. So as you see here, we are on Social Blade, socialblade.com. It's a website where companies and businesses can go to and put in, for this example, we have YouTube on the drop-down menu, but they can look up your YouTube, Twitch, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, TikTok, Daily Motion, Mixer, DJ Live, and Story Fire. Let's go ahead and look up my TikTok account. TikTok, Quincy C. Moreland. Let's hit search. It's checking the browser to make sure that it's working with socialblade.com, and it shows that I have a B- if you're looking. The Morelands, it shows that I have 321,000 followers. 6.7 million likes, shows my rank, followers for the last 30 days, 100. And then of course, you can see my statistics, if you will. It looks like it shows for the last 3 weeks. So on the left, you see the dates. On the right here, you see the followers. It's pretty consistent. And right here, you see how many have followed me each of those days. The reason why I show you this is because we are going to take a look at an unnamed account, like I mentioned. We are on this person's account. And what I want to specifically show you, and I didn't show the top because I don't want to show their name, but what it says at the top that you can't see is TikTok stats summary / user statistics for the person's name. And it shows from July 16th of this year to July 28th. And what I want to show you is on July 16th right here, which was a Thursday, probably when they first bought followers, either purchased 978,800 followers right away, just to make it seem like they're almost at the million mark. And then what they did, and it's because I've actually reviewed the account, is they uploaded about 26 videos. And after getting some clout and comments legitly in real time of real people, what you see that they did on July 17th, which is the next day, is they went ahead and bought 21,200 followers just to give it that exact 1 million mark. Once they're at 1 million, They're not exactly satisfied with that. Seems kind of fishy. Someone might realize that I bought 1 million followers. Let me just shift it up a little bit, and one day later, let me just buy 100,000 so at least it can be 1.1 million followers. I'm not saying this to try to target someone. I am just using this as an example. If you know this is your account, don't say anything and no one will know it's you. But using this as an example, I went ahead and clicked on their Instagram and their YouTube. And when you click on their YouTube account, what you see is their followers only have 3 or 4 or 5 pictures on each of their followings. And so that tells you right now that all of their followers are bots. They're not real. And the reason why I say this is because when companies look at you to want to sponsor you, whether your name's Tammy, Tiffany, John, Kenneth, Keith, oh man, they have 1 million followers. And on Instagram, they have 200,000 followers. You know, we should work with them. And what they do is they go to Social Blade, which is the number one site you can go to pull up everyone's social media accounts to look and see what's that engagement rate. Because the engagement rate between you and the followers, or you and the subscribers, are going to tell this person that they have influence. So say it was me who had 1 million followers on TikTok, they're gonna look at that engagement per video, or say, or maybe over the week or over the month, and what they're gonna look at is, okay, so he does comedy, and so if we gave him a shoe deal, could he sponsor these shoes and have enough engagement going back and forth between him and his fan base to where they might actually decide that they want to buy these shoes? On Instagram, if there's no engagement but you just have the number, they're gonna see instantly there's no engagement between him and the fan base, so this number is fake, and so we don't want to work with him. Down below, you see on July 23rd, another 100,000 followers were purchased to make it 1.2 million. Now, obviously, you can see on 717 that it's possible to show 20,000, 30,000, 10,000, or 15,000, but on July 23rd, let's just go ahead and buy another 100,000. And so I told you guys that I was going to show you what happened when I bought followers on my Instagram account. I saw this from a different influencer who was on YouTube. They now have this huge following, and she said that she had bought followers on Instagram because she was curious on what would happen, and she would never do it again because it really messed up her account. And so I did the same thing. I said, okay, you know, if she did it, I'm gonna do it too, just so I could at least learn. I had a certain number of followers on Instagram, and then I decided to do something crazy, and that was to buy between 1,800 and 2,000 followers. Worst mistake ever. And I knew it was gonna happen because I had already did the research, but I just wanted to see for myself. And sure enough, I bought the followers. It jumped me way over 2,400 followers on Instagram, and I posted videos after, which were cool, legit, fun comedy videos, and even maybe pictures. And there was no engagement. There wasn't the 2,400 follower engagement. There was only 20 to 30 people engaging. It hurts your engagement. You know, they're gonna look at your engagement on Instagram and say, oh, is it 3%? Is it 5%? Does he have 6 to 7% engagement? Oh, let's see this spike that went up in his follower base. Oh, but where's the engagement, you know, from the spike of followers and then the post right after the spike? So this is why I'm telling you it's a bad idea to buy followers on TikTok, Instagram, or even YouTube subscribers, because they will begin to taper off and drop off. I don't know what's in the system or the platform, but the followers that I bought on Instagram last year, sure enough, they begin to drop by the 5s, by the 10s, by the 15s. And now my Instagram following is exactly where it's supposed to be. At some point you'll see, oh, okay, yeah, this is kind of where I started off at before I made the stupid decision to buy followers. I'm gonna read to you in the TikTok creator marketplace on what brands are looking for when they go through your profile and decide if they wanna work with you or not. So let's go ahead and read that. Review invitations from brands. Brands can search TikTok creator marketplace for creators like you and see your profile, audience demographics, engagement metrics, and more if they are interested in working together on a campaign. And if I'm a company and I'm going on Social Blade and I see that all of a sudden you have 100,000 followers, you know, on one day, but not the next and the next and the next just like boom here, boom here, boom, it instantly shows that you're buying followers. And there's no hate here. I just want to be able to do a video to show you that it can hurt you, because if you've worked so hard to get somewhere, and then all of a sudden you've had this itch and this urge to buy subscribers or followers just to get to that number, are you getting to that number because you want to see the number, or you want to have the actual followers? And I know the intention, but there is a difference, as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, there's a difference between the number of followers and actually being famous. You can have 1 million followers according to what your profile says above your picture, but 1 million people do not actually know you. And that's the difference between being famous and having a follower count. No one knows who you are. So this is just a reason why you wouldn't want to buy your following, and you want to grow it organically. If you're looking for ways to grow your following on TikTok, I've created a video for that. That will be in the link. Other videos might pop up right here. How to genuinely and authentically engage with your fan base. You should find those links down there below. And I want to be able to show you how you can, you know, move forward going into 2021. So hey, you know what? I just wanted to share this quick video on why it's a bad idea, what I did, what the results were, and how you can avoid even trying. Don't even bother with it. Don't even itch to go purchase something just so you can see that number, because like I said, there is a difference between the actual numbers and people actually knowing you, or you actually having a real influence if you're not getting the engagement and you're posting after you get this spike but no one's commenting. If you like this video, if it was really beneficial to you, make sure you share it with someone who can gain this knowledge as well and this insight, so they don't make the same mistakes. And hey, I'll see you on the next video. Also, let me know what type of videos you would like for me to make. Put it in the comments, and I'll see you real soon.